Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Bronwyn and I am a skincare specialist by trade with 8+ years of experience career-wise and here on YouTube. And today I'm going to be talking about Ren Skincare and specifically focusing on their Evercalm range. And I have been using this range for about 1.5 years to almost 2 years now, and for some reason I've never given it a dedicated video, so today that is exactly what I want to do for you guys. If you're not familiar with the brand Ren Skincare, you can find them at stores like Sephora and Ulta, and they are a brand that focuses on gentle ingredients for the skin that are dermatologist tested and cruelty free. They have a lot of products in their range that are catered to people with more sensitive and dry skin rather than people with, say, oily skin or normal skin types. Which is why it's one of the brands that I found myself interested in as someone who suffers with sensitive, very dry, and aging skin. Ren Skincare is a brand that was founded in the year 2000, and they focus on clean beauty before clean beauty really was a trend. So they limit the amount of ingredients that have potentially been known or some people find can be harmful to the body to use. Now, of course, the term clean beauty is totally something that one decides to believe in or not. There really is no scientific founding behind the terms clean and beauty and what that entirely encompasses, as a lot of ingredients that people feel are dangerous to use on the skin actually are proven to not be by science, but that is something for a whole other video. But Ren Skincare has believed in clean beauty for a number of years and were founded based on clean beauty and limiting the amount of ingredients that are chemical based and focusing more on gentle, natural, non-irritating ingredients for the skin. Aside from that, they claim to be a sustainable brand and have been a sustainable brand since they were founded as well. So if that's something that you're interested in, it is of course good to know. The products in particular I'm going to be talking about today are from the Evercalm line. This is a line that is dedicated to people with sensitive skin types that are more on the dry side and need products and ingredients that are going to focus on nourishing the skin, maintaining that moisture barrier to help keep them protected from irritants that could affect them throughout the days or just on the day to day as their skin type is more sensitive. The first product I'm going to be introducing to you guys is one I'm a little bit skeptical about, to be honest. This is the Evercalm Global Protection Day Cream. And with a name like that, it gives the impression that it is a form of SPF. But believe it or not, which I was surprised about when I first got this product, it's not an SPF and it doesn't have any form of sun protection within this product. So I do personally find the name of the product to be somewhat misleading just because global protection sounds like a global UV protection SPF, but this product's not. So when you are looking at the Ren Skincare line, or if you have seen it before, do know that this has no form of SPF within it whatsoever. With that being said, what it does contain is a load of antioxidants. This is an antioxidant-rich day cream. So I guess the term protection comes from the use of antioxidants to help inhibit the negative effects of UV exposure throughout the day, which I find to be a bit controversial, to be honest, as you really should just be using an SPF at that point, and I do believe this is a product that should contain at least an SPF 30 alongside the antioxidants to really be a protection day cream. To my surprise, this product retails at $49, which is crazy expensive for only 50 milliliters of product. And with the fact that it doesn't contain any SPF in it whatsoever as a day cream, it's a little bit unexciting, to be honest. It contains key ingredients such as blackcurrant seed oil, which is rich in omega-3s. It contains camellia oil to help replenish and nourish the skin. It also contains sea buckthorn berry, rich in omega-7. And it also contains a ton of other antioxidant-rich ingredients and stuff that's really going to help repair your cell barriers. They have a huge ingredient list here, so I'm just going to name off a few that I see right in it, but of course I can also insert that ingredients list in the video so you guys can really get an idea of what exactly makes this cream so expensive. It has cetyl alcohol, which is a fatty alcohol to help moisturize the skin. Then it has that camellia seed oil as the third ingredient, which is the one that is a nourishing and recovery skin cell replenishing oil. Then we also have sesame oil in there, which is interesting as I don't see that too often in skincare products. Then we have shea butter, we have a few triglycerides, we have sunflower seed oil, that cranberry oil, that black currant seed oil, We have hippopharamnoids, which is a huge antioxidant player. So I'm excited to see hippopharamnoids in there, as it's more of an ingredient that's more common in Korean skincare and not something you see too often in Western. There's rosemary in here as well, but it is closer to the lower end of the ingredients list, which doesn't get me too concerned. However, rosemary doesn't have a huge amount of benefits for the skin, and if anything, it can lead to irritation in some really sensitive groups. So I'm finding that's probably more of a fragrance additive. However, even though this doesn't have any added perfumes, it does have ingredients in there that do play as fragrances on the natural level. But when you smell it, it kind of has a florally scent to it, but it's not too strong whatsoever. And that really is it for the Global Protection Day Cream. And to be honest, this isn't one of my favorite products from the Evercom skincare line. I find it just lackluster, even though it is supposed to be this antioxidant-rich, omega-rich, replenishing skin cell cream. I just don't feel like I get any real benefit to using this product comparatively to other products that I prefer to use, where I feel like I really do notice a difference in my skin when I use them compared to when I don't use them. And the fact that this doesn't have SPF in it is really not thrilling for me whatsoever. The next product that I have from the Evercom line is one of my favorites. This is the Anti-Redness Serum. And I was surprised. I am almost done this bottle and I loved using this in the summer. Similar to the Global Protection Day Cream, this is a product that is focused on antioxidant care, replenishing skin cells to keep that moisture barrier intact to limit the amount of irritation that you can get, while also giving hydration to the skin. So if you find you have dry skin, but you also have a lot of dehydration with your skin, this is a great serum to incorporate into your routine, because it's a combination of that hydration and nourishment factor that's really going to be almost enough in the summer season for your skin. And I know currently right now we're in the winter season, so we find ourselves needing a little more moisture, especially if you're a dry skin person like me. This might not cut it on its own, but if you incorporate this into your routine as a hydrating and nourishing layer underneath your daytime SPF cream, you're really going to notice a difference in your skin. I just loved this. My skin was glowing, my skin was plump, my skin overall just felt really healthy when I was using this. Now, in terms of its ability to combat irritation, I didn't really see a difference in my skin, but mind you, I overall don't experience irritation too often, just because my skincare routine really does revolve around maintaining my skin's barrier. So me experiencing irritation is more when I'm sampling new products, specifically makeup, where I will have a flare up, but otherwise totally fine and didn't really notice a huge difference in terms of irritation control with this product. Surprisingly enough, the Evercom Anti-Redness Serum does retail for a few dollars more, running at $52, which again is really overpriced for what you're getting, in my opinion. There's 30 milliliters in this bottle, which is even smaller than the day cream, the Global Protection Day Cream that we saw earlier. And the ingredients are very similar in that regard. We have microalgae extract, which is an antioxidant repairing ingredient for the skin to help keep it hydrated and strengthen that moisture barrier. Then again, we have lingon berry seed oil, which is another fatty acid cream. So similar to the other ingredients from the Global Protection Serum, when we had those fatty omegas in there, we're also getting fatty acids again in this, but we're also getting some natural ceramides as well, which is great for anti-aging and also for maintaining moisture levels in your skin and retaining moisture in your skin. Those were the key ingredients for this product. When opening up the huge ingredients list, we're getting soybean oil, we're getting those triglycerides, we're getting glycerin for hydration, we're getting that algae extract. We have lactose in there, which is a little bit interesting to see. I feel like lactose can be more so common in acne-fighting ingredients, so interesting to see that there. Sodium hyaluronate is in the middle of the list, so that's giving you your hydration levels. We have milk protein as well, which is good for strengthening your skin cell barrier. Sunflower seed oil, we have that rosemary again, similarly in the lower level of the ingredients list, so I'm assuming that's part of their fragrance. We have lactic acid, which again is a gentle kind of acne treatment and is often used for people who don't do well with harsher acids. So it's interesting to see lactic acid there in there, even though it's at the lower end of the ingredients list. Then we have a bunch of plant extracts in there. So it's an interesting mix of ingredients that they use in the serum, but for some reason it really did work for me. My skin loved it. It was just the right amount of moisture and hydration in the summer season that I felt I didn't need many other skincare ingredients aside from like a really hydrating toner, a functional serum, this as my kind of lotion, and then finishing it off with a really lightweight SPF 50, and I was set for the summer season. So this one gets a plus for me, even though the price tag on it is way too much for what it is, in my opinion. The next product that we have from the Ever Calm line is their Gentle Cleansing Milk. And I know cleansing milk isn't for everyone, but honestly, if you have really dry, sensitive skin, hop on the cleansing milk train. If you don't, you will probably wonder why you haven't when you start using it. I was against cleansing milks for the longest time, for years. I thought they didn't do anything. I thought they were pointless. I thought they would just break me out and clog my pores, but I was totally wrong because I was using them wrong. I am always using a cleansing milk now because my skin is so dry, it really can't handle any kind of cleansing foam, cleansing gel, or any real other cleanser aside from a cleansing milk. Now, I only really use this in the morning if I really feel like I need to just wash my face, and then using it at night after a cleansing oil, specifically after a cleansing oil, not on its own, especially if I'm wearing SPF or makeup. I really need to use that cleansing oil first to lift that out of my pores, really make sure I get everything off my face, and then go in and second cleanse with a cleansing milk to remove the excess oil without stripping any moisture from my skin. And that is exactly what I do and what I have been using this for, and I've been loving it. This really has helped to combat my dryness in my skin and my dehydration levels after cleansing at night. It's super, super gentle. When I rinse my face, I don't get that super tight feeling after I use water on my skin. And my skin doesn't get clogged pores after either, which I was really surprised about. Now, like most cleansing products, the ingredients list don't matter too much because they are getting rinsed off your skin. But with a cleansing milk, it is a little more imperative to pay attention just because it does leave a bit of a residue on the skin after cleansing. This one is really gentle and really consistent ingredients with the other products from the Evercom line. You have that sesame oil in there, which I assume is their favorite form of moisturizing oil. You got that shea butter in there. You got that sunflower oil. You got the hypoflavonoids, which is interesting to see in a cleanser, as those are really powerful antioxidants. You got the chamomile oil or camellia oil. Honestly, like, the ingredients list on here are super, super similar to their Global Protection Day Cream, which is really interesting to see, as this is the cleansing version of that. There are a ton of other ingredients that I'm going to list on the screen for you guys if you're curious, and you can look into it for yourself, but similar ingredients to that day cream, only this is the wash-off version. The next product from the Everclam line that is probably my top favorite out of everything from this line is the Overnight Recovery Balm. I have been using this for almost 2 years now, and I still have about maybe just under half the jar left. And I gotta say, this is one of my all-time favorites, especially if you have super dry skin and in the winter time. I strictly use this the most in the winter time as my night cream because it is so nourishing and moisturizing and recovering for dry, damaged, irritated skin. It just is the perfect amount that my skin needs in the winter time when I'm suffering from dryness from the winter season. It doesn't break me out. It keeps me super moisturized and my skin healthy. And even if I'm having a really bad irritation patch of dryness, itchy skin, tight face, this, when I wake up in the morning, makes it feel so much better. Surprisingly enough, this retails at $48, so it's actually cheaper than their serum, which is surprising because I do find I get more of a benefit when using this compared to the serum itself. Its key ingredients are enzymatically activated oils such as olive oil, almond oil, and borage and linseed oil. So a lot of heavy oils to help nourish the skin's moisture barrier and help to keep it really, really moisturized. It has beta-glucan in there, which helps to calm and soothe the skin. And beta-glucan is an ingredient that you'll really see often in Korean skincare products. So it's really exciting to see it here in a Western brand. Aside from that, the additional ingredients of this product is another fairly large ingredients list. The top ingredients are those oils that we previously listed after glycerin and water. Then we have jojoba extract or jojoba oil, which I'm surprised that they didn't list in their key oils, because jojoba oil is one of the oils that closely similars that of the oil that our skin naturally produces and is one of the best oils to use if you have dry and super, super sensitive skin. So I'm surprised they didn't list that there. It also has beeswax, which is pretty common in any kind of balm type product. You got that cetyl alcohol, which is another fatty alcohol for moisturizing the skin. And that's it. Honestly, it's just a mix of emulsifiers and heavy oils, but it really works for me personally. If you have really dry, sensitive, damaged skin, I'd definitely give this a try or get a sample size, because the price tag on this is pretty heavy for the amount that you get, which is 30 milliliters again. However, like I said, this has lasted me almost 2 years. So even though it's a heavy price, it does last if you're using it not consistently. And the last thing that I have from Ren Skincare that I want to share with you guys today is one I don't like whatsoever. This is their Clean Screen Mineral SPF 30. And it's just like, honestly, I really didn't like it. It is mostly a physical SPF, which is totally fine. I normally am fine with physical SPFs. With that being said, it does leave a white cast on there. It is 22% zinc oxide, which is the physical aspect of the SPF. And it just like the white cast on this is so apparent, and it feels very, very, very heavy on the skin. This is in no way a light SPF. When I tried using this, it just felt like I was walking around with a thick mask on my face. It didn't sit nicely under my makeup. It didn't merge well with my additional skincare products. And it just honestly was very uncomfortable to wear on the face. It felt like my skin wasn't breathing whatsoever. And it just wasn't a pleasant user experience at all, really. This is a vegan and cruelty-free product, so if there are any vegans out there, that is something to note if you are interested in trying it out. It has a massive ingredients list, which is interesting to see, just because they are taking consideration of having those skincare benefits in their product, which I do love to see. I feel like a lot of Western North American brands, skincare-wise, don't really focus too much on adding skincare benefits to their day cream SPFs, and instead just make an SPF that works for the face and call it a day and market it as this amazing thing that you should be spending $50 on, you know? But this actually has similar ingredients to the Evercom line to help really keep the skin nourished, healthy, and unsensitized to external factors. One thing that I saw on their large ingredients list is it does have those hippopharamnoids in there, which is those powerful antioxidants for nourishing and protecting the skin. We do have a lot of consistent oils in there, such as Hoewood leaf oil. We have that cranberry seed oil antioxidant. We have the aloe vera on the top of the ingredients list, which I do personally really like to see. However, this product is so heavy, you wouldn't even guess there's aloe vera in there. You've got that sunflower seed oil. You have that rosemary in there, which is consistent throughout all of their products that I've seen, and a bunch of other ingredients to help make the formulation what it is. Honestly, like, it did great for its ability to block out the UV rays, but the user experience, again, was just very unpleasant. It was very thick. It was very heavy. Throughout the day, I was aware that there was something on my face. It's not like when you apply other SPFs, specifically Korean SPFs, and it just feels like the rest of your skincare. This actually felt like a thick mask that was a veil over my skin throughout the entire day that I had it on, and I didn't really want to use it ever again. Anyway, you guys, that is my mini brand review on the Ren Skincare line. Have you used any of these products from the brand? Let me know your thoughts. It really was focused on their Evercom line, as those are really the only products that I've been gifted from them in the past. Yes, this is gifted products, but I got it 2 years ago, so this is in no way supported or required of me to talk about them. This was me doing it on my own. But again, like, it's just a lot of the products are a hit and miss for me. If I had to repurchase anything, it would 100% be that balm, which I'm in love with. After that, I might repurchase the cleansing milk as I am really enjoying it, and I usually hate most cleansing milks. So definitely let me know if you've used any of these products before, or if you're curious about the Ren skincare line. I would love to hear your guys' thoughts and opinions on that. If you want to see more videos like these, definitely let me know in the comment section down below, and thumbs up this video to support. Give me a subscribe. I upload videos every single week here on YouTube that are mostly skincare related, fashion related, hair occasionally, and makeup occasionally. Thank you guys so much for watching. Check me out on my Instagram account to see the kind of stuff that you're not going to see here, and I will catch you next time.